Hey, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss. And over the last month or so, there's been a lot of hype around the Dia browser because essentially it allows you to chat with your tabs and they're rolling out access to most people. So it's like AI in your web browser. But what if I told you there's an open source version of Dia and it works with any Chromium-based browser, so you can install it on Chrome and immediately you have AI superpowers in your browser? That's what this little Chrome extension OpenDia is hoping to do. It's as easy as going to the releases section, downloading the file, and then installing it in your Chrome extensions. If you look at my Chrome extensions, here's my little YouTube transcript extractor I made, but next to that, here's OpenDia working in my browser. Now I can choose an AI model of my choice to chat with and control my web browser. You might have noticed over here, I've got Claude Desktop loaded up. All you need to do is edit the Claude Desktop configuration file. Once that's done, you'll be able to pop in here and see that actually OpenDia is installed as an MCP tool, and it can do a bunch of stuff on your browser. So let's give it a go. Just to show you this in action, you'll see OpenDia as an extension in my browser here, disconnected. But when I fire up Claude, you'll see that it suddenly fires up over here, loads the MCP server, and we should get a green light over here to say that we're connected. And we are. So when we are, I'll just say, read the article on this page, The Verge here, talking about Dia, and create a Twitter thread summarizing the main points. And you'll see that Claude will actually call OpenDia, and it should give me, there it is, page analysis, it's doing it. Let me extract the article, we just allow this, and boom, perfect. I can see the article is about Dia, the new browser from the browser company. It's drafting an artifact here, a Twitter thread, all about the Dia browser. Look at that. Boom, straight away from an article I'm reading on The Verge, OpenDia has summarized it and made it into a perfect thread that I can post on Twitter, or X if you prefer. I've fired up a new chat session. I've got this Reddit thread all about Dia browser first impressions, and I'll just say, tell me the main points from the Reddit thread on this page. And now we'll let Claude take control of that with its wonderful connection to OpenDia. It's again asking for permission. I made this bigger so you can see everything that's being summarized here. And there's quite a lot of stuff here, including AI integration reception, trust and monetization, target audience, overall sentiment, cautious optimism, underwhelming launch, waiting for features, and beta considerations. There you go, Reddit summarized at the tips of my fingers using OpenDia. But let's go even more advanced with this. And this time, I'm going to trust it with my browser history. Look through my browser history from this week and summarize the GitHub repos I checked out. We'll send that to Claude, which should call the OpenDia MCP server. And boom, there we go. Just allow always here. And now it can view all of my history. And look at this. Main repositories visited. OpenDia, Home Assistant, OmniTools, Zapier, browsing patterns. You also spent considerable time browsing GitHub's trending repositories, 11 visits and 2 visits to the daily, which suggests you're actively exploring new and popular projects in the developer community. Additionally, you perform searches for Home Assistant repositories, indicating focused research into home automation solutions. The pattern suggests you're interested in browser automation tools, home automation. Wait a minute, an MCP server that can read all of your browsing history? How do you feel about that? Let me know in the comments down below. So that's OpenDia, an open source browser extension that allows AI models to automatically control your web browser. No need to get Dia. It can look at your logged in accounts, saved passwords, cookies, browsing history, and everything else. It can pretty much be your browsing companion. I'll make sure to place a link to this, should you want to try it yourself, in the description down below. You know, on this channel, we're all about building apps and agents using no-code tools, so you might be a little bit surprised to hear what I've been learning lately to level up my AI game. Actual code. And here's why. To truly orchestrate AI and build more powerful custom automations, understanding the basics of code, particularly Python, is a superpower. My favorite AI coding tool, Cursor, even proves this. They recently changed their pricing, and now the do-it-for-me agent requests are limited, but code auto-completions for people who know the basics of coding are unlimited, and that tells me everything. That's exactly why I've been loving this course on Skillshare, Coding 101 Python for Beginners. Now, it's not about becoming a master developer. It's simply about learning to speak the language of AI, and the instructor is a former UC Berkeley lecturer and makes it very, very practical. You don't even need to install anything, you just jump right in, building little projects that help you understand the logic so that you can better guide your AI tools that are generating all this code in front of your face. Learning has been super helpful for how I work with AI, and the great thing is, You don't just have to learn about AI. Skillshare has thousands of classes across tons of categories like art and illustration, animation, photography, graphic design, and productivity. And Skillshare want you to try it too. The first 500 people to use my link in the description or scan the QR code will receive a one-month free trial of Skillshare.
Now, this is definitely the week of web browsers as Perplexity announced Comet, where you can browse at the speed of thought. No longer pointing and clicking, we're going to a more agentic web where you'll be able to use natural language to vibe browse websites. Examples are you can browse to a competitor's website, also find Reddit threads, and ask Comet to summarize all of that stuff. Now, it's highly personal. It learns how you think, collaborates on your research, and keeps your digital life organized. For instance, I've seen examples where you can take an X post, analyze it, post something back, and even look at your YouTube comments. It's very powerful, obviously powered by Perplexity, and you can go off and do things such as summarize web pages, shop, schedule ideas, and send messages to people. So this is going to be a big productivity hack. It's going to save you a lot of time from doing your usual browsing activities. Now that Comet is here, how can we actually get it? Well, first and foremost, you're going to need to either join the waitlist, as I'm just doing there, or upgrade to the Perplexity Max plan, which is presently $200 a month. Now, if Perplexity want to give me access to try Comet, I'm more than happy to create a video review on it, but I do think presently $200 is rather steep for an agentic web browser when you've already got Dia browser and OpenDia, as we've just seen at the start of this video. By the way, if you're not a member of my free community, you should be. Link is down below. I'm in Scotland this week, hence the mobile setup, and hosted a mini meetup in Glasgow, where a few of us gathered together, well, namely Scott, myself, and Dave, and we had a cup of coffee at Launch Coffee in Prince's Square Shopping Centre. It was awesome. We chatted AI, and I'm hoping for more of this stuff in the future. Thanks, guys. Finally, this week, we're shooting for the stars. Well, certainly Elon is, with Grok 4.
This is the smartest AI in the world.
Now available for you to test out. Yes, if you're a Super Grok user, you can switch over to Grok 4, or you can get Super Grok Heavy, which currently comes in at $3,000 a year, but gives you access to the most advanced model of Grok. So, what do you get for your money? Well, I'm going to switch over to Grok 4. You'll notice there's no deep search or thinking at the moment. You can indeed attach things, but I'm just going to simply prompt it. I'd like you to create me a space-themed game. The most important thing for you to get right is ensure that the graphics are super, super cool. Okay, we'll run that prompt with Grok 4 and see what comes back. First of all, it's going to think things over. Now, it's already got access to a Python interpreter with libraries that it can work with. Now you can see it's actually executing code on the back end, testing things out before it hands over to me. This is impressive stuff. And boom, after thinking for 40 seconds, it's beginning to write out some code here. Now, I'm not sure how advanced the graphics are going to be in this game, but we'll certainly give it a go. There it is, pip install pygame and then run spaceadventures.py as a single file of code. I'm not that confident, but let's test. Okay, I'm just installing pygame. There it is. And now we'll run the command to start it. And here is my space game. And I've got to say, as long as I don't crash, this is actually insanely good for, well, what we were producing a while back that didn't have these floating stars and these really good looking ships. I like it. And am I going to die if I fall into one of these ships? Maybe not quite yet. Oh, yes, I did die. A pretty good start, but let's see where Grok 4 can take this. Okay, I'm really impressed with what you've created so far, but focus on making the graphics even better and use extra files so you can expand the functionality of the game. So with this prompt, I'm actually asking Grok to think outside the box, improving the graphics and also maybe even adding some extra files to expand the game's playability. I like it. It's already throwing in explosion effects and it's searching for free space shooter game assets. So it's already reaching out to the web to find some cool graphics for my game. And it looks like it's found a nice library that it might use. This is really cool agentic stuff, and it's an example of Grok's superpower of spinning up mini agents to go off and do jobs to make you the ultimate solution. Now it's actually looking for WAV and MP3 files to use in the game. This is really cool. Okay, so it thought for just over 2 minutes, and now it's pumping out a load of Python code, which is all broken down into different modules. So now I'm going to go ahead and make the files for each different game. Now I'm going to go to these links that Grok provided and download the assets. And we'll see right here under Creative Commons License CC0, meaning I can use it in my game, a lovely bundle that I can use. This is pretty insane. Okay, so these are the graphic assets downloaded. Now we've got some audio files to download. And I'm impressed. Both times, Grok found me brilliant assets that I can download straight away. That is a hack I've not found any other AI model can do well. Okay, all images in the images folder, sounds in the sounds folder, all recommended by Grok 4. Let's just run Python main.py and see what happens. Now this is pretty insane. Although I couldn't seem to move my ship. Note the controls are not working, but it's definitely pulling graphics in. Now just because I'm a stickler for getting this working, let's actually go to the cursor agent and say, game looks pretty good, but it's not playable. Please make it playable so I can move the ship and dodge the oncoming asteroids. This is my final get out of jail free card by running the cursor agent to see if it can fix things up and make me a playable game. And now it seems to have done that. Let's run the Python game one more time. This time we've got any key to start. I'm still getting infinity effects. Oh, and I am getting sound effects as well. That's not bad. The only thing I'm not digging is the infinity vibe on this, but let's press the game again. Pretty awesome that Grok sourced the graphics and the sound effects for this game. And with a little bit more vibe coding inside Grok 4 and Cursor's autonomous agent, I reckon we can get a pretty playable space game that can do some really cool stuff. What really impresses me is Grok went out to the web to find me these graphics.
And that's it for this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss. I really hope you've enjoyed this video and some of the tools. Let me know your favorite down below. And also, we continue the discussion as always in my community. It's there, open and buzzing with over 12,000 members. So make sure to join Creator Magic and I'll link the community link down below. Oh, and by the way, YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.